Lumbar puncture is a very controversial topic, and you can refer my earlier videos on when we should do lumbar puncture in suspected cases. In early onset sepsis, all the babies who have a high inflammatory marker, which is not explained by other factors like aspiration pneumonia, and babies with positive blood culture, or any baby with a neurologic symptom with suspected infection should get a lumbar puncture. In late onset sepsis, the likelihood of meningitis is more, and so we should have a lower threshold. We should consider LP as part of the sepsis screen, and if it is not done at that stage for any reason, you can follow a similar approach if you have a high inflammatory marker or a positive blood culture, or if the baby has neurologic symptoms, you should do. It's very important to document your plan for the lumbar puncture in the notes, and if the parents disagree for any reason, that should be clearly documented as well. The only exception where a baby with a positive blood culture doesn't get the lumbar puncture is where we have a coagulase negative staphylococcus sepsis. Most of the time, this infection is not known to cause meningitis, and so we don't necessarily do a lumbar puncture in these cases. We consider herpes PCR in any newborn with rash and features of sepsis, or high fever in a baby with encephalopathic features. So we should treat the baby with acyclovir while waiting for results, and this often proves to be a problem because the results may take 1 week or so, and the baby needs to be exposed to this IV medication for that period of time. This is just to give a summary of what we are looking at in the CSF in babies without meningitis. So outside this range would mean you consider meningitis. So the age is a parameter. You have the white cell count, we have the protein and the glucose. We also send the Gram stain and the culture. It's very important that the CSF sample is analyzed quickly, so that a delay in analysis may affect your glucose levels. It can affect your cell counts as well. A traumatic lumbar puncture is very difficult to interpret because the red blood cells would be high, and the white cells which are high in the blood may represent or reflect in the CSF as well. The correction factors are not always accurate, so even though if it is just a few slight smearing of blood in the CSF, you can do some correction. If it's frankly blood stained, you just send it for culture and you have to ignore the rest of the parameters. So you can see that the cell count is going up to 0 to 30 in term babies, and the protein count is slightly higher compared to normal babies. The preterm babies have a slightly higher protein content as well. The glucose roughly you compare the glucose to the blood glucose range, and obviously you need to do the sugar before the lumbar puncture so the stress does not cause the rise in the blood glucose level.